An arc of length 18 meters subtends a central angle of 280 degrees in a circle, as pictured below. The arc length of 18 meters is this length here. We're asked to find the circumference of the circle as well as the area of the circle. We'll first have to find the radius using the arc length formula. Recall the arc length formula is S arc length equals R the radius times the central angle theta, where theta must be in radians, which means for the first step we need to write 280 degrees in radians. We begin by writing 280 degrees as a fraction with the denominator of 1, and we multiply by pi divided by 180 degrees. Simplifying before multiplying, the units of degrees simplify out, and 180 and 280 share a common factor of 20. 180 divided by 20 is equal to 9. 280 divided by 20 is equal to 14, which indicates 280 degrees is equal to 14 pi divided by 9 radians. And now going back to our arc length formula, because we know the arc length S is 18, and now we know the angle theta in radians, we can determine the radius R. Our equation is 18 equals R times theta, where theta is 14 pi divided by 9. To solve for R, we multiply both sides by the reciprocal of 14 pi divided by 9, which is 9 divided by 14 pi. Notice on the right side, the product of the reciprocals is 1. R times 1 is R, which gives us R equals, let's write 18 as a fraction with the denominator of 1. Notice 14 and 18 share a common factor of 2. There are 7 2s in 14, 9 2s in 18. We have R equals 81 divided by 7 pi. Now that we have R, we can determine the circumference as well as the area. The circumference C is equal to 2 pi R, which in our case is 2 pi times the radius, which is 81 divided by 7 pi. Simplifying before multiplying, pi divided by pi simplifies to 1. Nothing else simplifies. The circumference is equal to 2 times 81 divided by 7, which is 162 divided by 7. And because the arc length is in meters, so is the circumference. And the decimal approximation here is 23.14 meters. But again, we should not round unless we're told to. The exact circumference is 262 divided by 7 meters. Now let's find the area. The area is equal to pi r squared, which gives us pi times the square of 81 divided by 7 pi, which equals pi times the square of 81 divided by the product of 7 squared and pi squared. Again, simplifying before multiplying, notice one factor of pi simplifies out. Pi squared simplifies to pi to the first, and the pi in the numerator simplifies to 1. 81 squared equals 6,561, which indicates the area is equal to 6,561 divided by 49 pi. And because this is the area, this would be meters squared. The decimal approximation here would be 42.62 square meters. But again, we should give the exact value unless we're told to round for the circumference, as well as the area. I hope you found this helpful.